something phenomenal happened on this kind of last year. I mean, half of all the web traffic was actually used to video. That's what people were talking about. And I was looking at the stats of YouTube. And about 200 million, so 200 hours of video was uploaded every single minute. And the rest of the time, the track is jump. Approximately 2 million users were watching the stream simultaneously, a single video. And this last year, YouTube has 1 billion users active, YouTube users in a single time. This is a big shift which is happening. On the distribution and the content delivery side, we're looking at what's happening on the platform side as well. So YouTube obviously delivers lower resolution videos like video that watches. Thank you. But the content is scheduled in this video, so there is one part of that actually watched by users. Right? The iOS 4K uncompressed video. Every video produces approximately 20 terabytes of video every day. And this content needs to be probably stored for decades to the lifetime, probably centuries. If you cannot imagine, there is no way some footage being lost after 100 years. That's not possible. This needs to be stored for years. 6 months is the content that's produced. But all the post-production that needs to happen on this. Last year, I learned that how to train the dragon to require 25 million compute hours to render all the code. This is the video of active distance. Probably more than some codes require even more compute power. All of this could have been a very tractable problem, right? Choose about the data, choose about the processing. If not, for the plan. If it was a uniform distribution of compute hours over a period of about 1 year or so, all the studios could have probably gone ahead and built larger and larger data centers. Whether it was a business or not, and still be able to solve this problem. How the rendering hours was actually used by one of the studio over a period of 6 months of moving production. And this was how it worked. This graph is an ultimate graph for anybody who's planning for capacity for that. But it also makes a case for public cloud where you can get elastic resources, where you can spin up hundreds or thousands of computers as required and then spin them down. The best ability for this virtual media topic is only 5%. This industry is facing myriads of media formats with all the codecs and standards and computer devices that this content is to be developed. Hard release dates. Irrespective of how much the cost is required, the producers have set the final release date constant and get those costs as much as they want. Complex tool chains that change all the time. In fact, every production almost seems like that. Seems like starting a new company. And get to use the workforce. Last week I was in India, and there were so many colleges and institutions where visual effects and animation degrees of certificates were being offered. Right? That's the distribution in different parts of the world. So studios are no longer at one location. And this workforce that is distributed across the world is probably working with the same project. And somehow we need to handle for this enormous data. And this challenge of data and problems at the one state of the reality. The time is the past. How do we adjust the huge amount of content into storage to the other applications with all the bandwidth and latency challenges that we have? How do you render all these things? With these two software technologies, that's how you get the software licenses that are required. This has all been called the provision for on-premises and now. How do you pass code for the million device formats? How do you apply this content? And it's not just storing this content for a long time at low cost. How do you work to retrieve the content as required? And then you need it in minutes. And distributing to users worldwide. So all these are the challenges that this industry faces. And Google Cloud Platform is actually investing substantial resources and infrastructure to address this problem. The essential cloud elements, which probably will be talked through the rest of the statistics today, that's a good topic. How can you spin up? If your users are deployed tens, hundreds, thousands of VMs, and spin down when you don't need them, and pay for exactly what you use. Always available storage. High performance block storage that you find on public cloud, but also can be seen low cost of archival but be able to recuperate. Global networking. Google has around 70 block edge locations across the world, and connected to massive network, including software and fibers, internet and outbound. And it's not just infrastructure investments we're talking about. Over the last year or so, my team has launched about 100 block features. It's extremely, and I guess, a very important block features. So, just for example, the more recent one is very relevant for the media industry, and we did talk about this in the last few minutes. The nearline storage, 34 VMs, integration of IBM, without processing and updating, HTTP code balancing, and more. So, why do we don't need to know any of that? Right? But if you just three words that you're going to pay for each from all of today's systems, it would be these. Okay. We are working really hard to make sure that the media industry can get a little bit of sophisticated way on the market side. How can we simplify the workforce to build a smart company that can actually produce software, plug it to their desktop host applications, or a large complex studio and to have a hybrid model to have an existing data hook that we're able to host the cloud? How can we do all this in a safe and secure manner? Google has hundreds of engineers, security engineers, many of them PhDs as well, working for you to keep your data safe and secure. These are the engineers who are trained to ward off most of the security attacks, including for the industries. They are the ones who will be working on this for you guys. And lastly, the economics. The real promise of cloud is what pay for exactly what you use, not for the entire hour, if you use it for a minute, pay for the minutes. You don't have to make a large commitment. The pricing should be simple, and if you use more, it's automatically getting out first because you have to buy it. So, throughout the next 4 to 6 hours, we try to address each of these elements for multiple systems. And I hope behold it. Most of that song currently covers multiple media outlets, from small studios, individual freelancers, studios that were graphics, resource, and then YouTube. Both are the largest media distribution companies out there. And we believe what we're doing. The book that you call upon, the top manager for the company, the group called Platform. Practice of Nick, it was last of Nick, and then so much of God, but I would not see the company as a